Welcome back to part two of Almost Pro Wrestling with me, Chloe. As usual, we're going to get straight to the action as half of the Cosplay King's assassin takes on Tribad's Haydon Tempest.
Tribad making another appearance here this evening. He is indeed another frustrated member of Tribad. Ejected from the building at the last show by our general manager, Fracture. Still annoys him. He was unable to pick up a win from Man. Well, it was Assassin who was dressed as John Cena. Assassin, of course, one of the Cosplay Kings. Suffering an attitude adjustment there. He's come back with an attitude today. And I'll tell you who's in his sight. Already seen his compatriot and former Tag Team Championship partner Paddy Flanagan in action this evening. Paddy was incredibly angry. His temper doesn't exactly have the best of temperaments either. Certainly one of the biggest and strongest men here in Almost Pro. Veteran of the Northeast wrestling scene. One half of the Cosplay Kings and founder member of the Generation of Destruction. Very popular here, as you can see, as he slaps the hands of the fans here at Almost Pro, in the Almost Pro Arena, on this lovely April afternoon. Oh, now he's handing out hugs. I think he might have caused a coronary there. And I don't mean from when he just jumped off that chair.
That video. Tip top. You can get that anywhere else.
Assassin very proud of his entrance video, and I'll tell you what, we do have a phenomenal setup here in the Almost Pro Arena, and he's right to point it out. And he might be all happy and smiles at the moment, but you just know underneath that, he will also be bubbling with frustration. Former tag team champion. He's also been unable to retain or regain even that gold. Put a lovely smiling face on it. Or perhaps he's just delaying the fact that very soon he'll have to get into that ring against one of the toughest members of Tribad. And I'm going to say that about all of them. In Haydon Tempest. charging like a raging bull. He knows an assassin will have seen that sort of thing before. He doesn't want to play into his little plan. Very similar in size and looks, but on the referee calls for the bend as these guys just launch into each other. It's each guy just trying to avoid each other's moves, but I'll tell you what, when one of these heavyweights just clucks with something like a clothesline or like you saw there, a massive thing, it's going to have an impact. I don't care how tough you are. Oh! That'll knock the wind out of your sails. Huge forearm to the chest. But he can't knock the big man down. I say the big man, both of these guys, very large individuals. Oh, but can he slam him? Yes, he can! I think that's taking the toll out of both men's backs. The slam on Haydon Tempest, but also the pressure on the spine of Assassin there as he lifted that massive individual up for that body slam. And now, Haydon Tempest is going to endure these chants from ringside from the fans calling him some sort of, it sounds like chicken man. Some sort of mutant hybrid. It is the worst of the X-Men. Oh, the assassin trying to get him in. Just dropped his neck on that top rope and now took Assassin out with a big clothesline. Tempest just, keeping Assassin down on the mat. This is probably a good idea. Just jumping on the ropes. Remember, we just have a 5 count. And here we go again as we look. Oh, Haydon Tempest is dropping the neck of Assassin onto that top rope before following up with that clothesline.
1, 2, 3.
And again, Haydon Tempest using the ropes as a weapon, if you will, using that ring as a weapon, utilizing that 5 count to his advantage every time. Doing it so well though. Again, it's another individual from Triband who wants to show that whilst he's great as a team, as a unit goes for cover, as great as a team, as a unit, he is also very dangerous in singles competition. As Assassin is learning right now. Headlock on, but Assassin back to his feet, and oh! He's not even letting Assassin catch his breath. As he just rings his bell in the corner. The corner box of Assassin. And look at the big grin on Haydon Tempest's face. The Assassin is now just taking off him. And like I said before, these two are really heavy hitters. These are the big guns, if you will. Oh, he's just positioned Assassin's leg on the ropes and taking full advantage of it as he just kicks into the thigh. Oh, it just drives that knee down. This time I think into the ankle of Assassin. Almost trying to fell this oak tree. Keep him in the corner as well. Just laying in it. Big, heavy blows and oh! Trying to charge in, but Assassin gets the elbow up, and I think you need to do that. Massive kick to the face. But put down with a spine buster.
3, 2,
Not enough. You saw Sasson there. He's like just come to the top of the pool to catch his breath. Because that really knocked the wind out of him. Especially having Haydon Tempest on top of you, trying to cover you as well. Now just measuring Assassin, he brings it to his feet. Oh! Assassin uses his wild sword. We know what this normally means. Can we sense it? It's the shinning and the neck breaker! Only two though. This is truly a war of attrition. Never mind just a battle. Sasson now asking the fans if he should go up top middle for a moonsault. And not only does he miss, he has landed heavily on that injured knee that Haydon Tempest just destroyed earlier on. He attacked the ankle, he attacked the thigh. When did that mean? I'll tell you what. Assassin hasn't done himself any favours. Look at that. Look at the look on Haydon Tempest's face. This could be a mistake. This is no time to gloat. He's not in there against Johnny Nobody, he's in there against Assassin. This is a guy who's won titles all around the region. He's a former tag team champion here. He has battled for the Almost Pro Championship on occasion. Whips him into the corner. Oh. Assassin just blocked out into the corner by nipping outside, showing great agility for a man his age and size. He just gyrates his hips and flies over. Splash isn't enough. Tempest manages to kick out. Assassin just feeling the pain in that leg right now, but trying to draw energy from the crowd by getting them to clap along. You know, Tempest looking a little groggy right now, gets to his feet. I think Assassin going for that contract, but Haydon Tempest having nothing to do with that. Oh, kick. Again, Assassin just defying gravity. Don't go see the 0-1-6-7-0, but instead just flings Haydon Tempest right over his head. Come look at that again. Look at the agility of this guy. He more or less flings Haydon Tempest using that leg strength into the ropes. Assassin now, on we know at least one wobbly leg, goes to the middle rope. Haydon Tempest facing the other way, probably doesn't know where Assassin is, he knows where he is now. Too late though! Oh, you think it was reversed into a powerbomb. And the smirk on the face of Haydon Tempest, because he thinks he has Assassin's number, is just replaced by that look of incredulity as the referee counts to, as he looks down at Assassin. He knows that he has the upper hand right now, but he needs to stay on him. He needs to focus. You can't lay up on Assassin for any length of time. Oh, charges the gun, but again misses. It's not been a good strategy. Oh, contract, I think. Signed, sealed, and oh, not delivered as the foot was on the ropes. Haydon Tempest managed to get his foot on the ropes. Jason's turn to look like a man who doesn't know what else he has to do, but you can absolutely be assured he's got something else in that bag of tricks. Haydon Tempest still down, trying to just grab onto those ropes. Knew where he was well enough to put his foot on those ropes. Not as bamboozled as you think, and oh, definitely not. Almost have you set the trap for assassin, but oh! Haydon Tempest put on assassin's shoulders and just slammed down. Will this be enough? It is! Let's get the official word.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, assassin!
What an absolute war out there. Arguably the two biggest men in Almost Pro have just had a fight that went way beyond any scale. Assassin though, the veteran, the guy who's been around the wrestling scene for around 20 years now, he knows he's been in a fight. I'm sure he's even got a grudging bit of respect for Haydon Tempest out of that. But it's that experience and that agility and all of those moves that he just managed to pull out of nowhere that you're just not expecting from a man his size. Give a lot of credit over here to Tempest. Although he'd be going back to try hard, much like his cohort Paddy Flanagan, with a loss this evening. The fans here in attendance in the Almost Pro Arena, very pleased with the victory here tonight for the perennial fan favourite, Assassin. Lots more action still to come this evening as Assassin almost cheerleading. Oh, and then sickeningly raises the referee's arm. And the fans react accordingly. His hooks are handed out to the referee. It makes you wonder.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Assassin!
Well, stay tuned for more action.
What a match, and an impressive win by Assassin. So last month, Weapon X made his singles debut, picking up a win against Lewis Ryan. This month, he takes on Kendoll. Let's go and see how it all went down.
Expect a fight, never mind applause.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen! Maybe he's winning the ring!
Ring announcer eventually announces Weapon X. Perhaps he was needing somebody to help him with the big words, like, I don't know, X, and he announced him there. Weapon X, though, who we saw in his single debut last show against Lewis Ryan. We've had some brutal battles tonight, but I'll tell you what, these two forced each other to the very limit. It was an incredible win from Weapon X, and he'll be wanting to improve on that. Well, he wants to improve on that this evening as he takes on Kendoll. Kendoll seems to pick and choose the TSCF in almost four. Oh, obviously thought that he could get the drop on Weapon X, and he has. Weapon X standing on the rope, just cheering for the fans, and Kendoll just comes in behind and attacks him, but now Weapon X recovered and just laying into Kendoll with elbows, and Kendall's out of there. He's not taking any more of that. Wonders to the goal. Look at this, we'll see that attack from behind again. Weapon X is just up on the middle rope, and this is a good strategy from Kendoll. He obviously watched the match between Weapon X and thought the best way to get the drop on this guy is attack from behind, and it works momentarily. So the referee there, Lewis Kelly, just telling Kendoll he has to get back in the ring, but before he does so, he has to get past Weapon X, and that was most effective. Dropping his neck on the ropes and now laying in with that kind of cross forearm elbow drop that he does. Only a one count. Always wise to go for a cover no matter when in the match. It only takes 3 seconds to win. And also it means your opponent has to exude energy and kick now. But look at this. If Weapon X sort of can avoid being pinned by lying face down, he's now going to contend with that submission as Kendoll just works over that arm just brutally. Again, going for cover. Very smart. Now he's gone from one count to two. It only takes 1 second more. And some might call this an upset. Bear in mind, Kendoll is the man who shot the Ishquell of a sword. Oh, just kicking the face there, just to call him in the action. But Kendoll, let's not forget it after he drops that leg and goes for that cover again. This is enough. This is the man who forced our champion into his first defense, Domonic Davenport, the showman, was taken to the limit by this guy. I mean, Kendoll showed so much in that match. Very impressive, but not there as he dives into the corner and, oh, arm drag. And a hip toss, a thing of beauty from Weapon X. Oh, kick to the burger box. The heavy hitting. Former champion of contract. He was, of course, the hardcore champion there for a fair while. He's just showing exactly why he held that championship for so long. Kendoll, though, no slouch. On that top rope, double axe handle. As he laid him out. Not quite, still a two count, but again, Kendoll going for every chance he can to try and just buy a quick win. That's smart because, quite frankly, you want to win and live another day. And now he's going for that ankle lock. And Weapon X is very close to that rope. Don't know if he can reach out. He can use a bit of power as well. Yes, he's got it. Of course, Kendoll has a five count to break that hold. If the referee reaches five, that will be a disqualification. Oh! And Weapon X just giving a jawbreaker to Kendoll and just playing back in with those punches. Referee wants to look for closed hands there. Oh ho ho! beautiful Peter fling knee from
two, one, two, two.
Only two.
Kendoll sucks.
Well, there goes a chalk. Kendoll doing everything he can. He's really taking the two weapon axe. Drive that elbow into the mostly awkward board of the season. Rotate across from the board. Now he's behind him, stalking him. Trying to get back to his feet. Oh! That's a close, like, no. Weapon X. Oh! Suplex rolls around. Keeps a hold. Oh, push the button, he's done. Kendall's turn to kick out on the count of two this time. This is Weapon X's opportunity. Different sort of fight than he had last month against Lewis Ryan. Kendoll, a much smaller man, but more resourceful, as we've seen on many occasions here. Oh, look at that blocking moves from Weapon X. Oh, shot on close behind. Is this enough boost for that cover?
Oh,
two and a half. Kendoll is not pleased. As I said before, this is a brilliant strategy. This is great. Going for the pinfall every opportunity he can. It could be that if he's wrung Weapon X's bell enough, that he might just, you know, counter throw you. Just get what may be called an upset here. But right now, there's no upset as he's just being marched from the ring. And oh, power slam from Weapon X. Kendoll kicking out with desperation. He's getting frustrated. That's not a good place for him to be. Guys in the corner. Kendoll moves. Picks him up. Oh, he's on his shoulders. Oh, drops him down almost. Michinoku driver style. Let's look at this parading power slam. Not quite enough there because Kendoll is back on his feet. Has full advantage over Weapon X right now. Is now he's got Weapon X on his shoulders. Oh, sunset flip! And he's got it!
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the match, Weapon X!
Well, I'll tell you what, the strategy that Kendoll employs was absolutely brilliant, trying to get a pin. Went for a cover on every opportunity he could, and it seemed to be fair and true. Could have got a win from that, but Weapon X has turned the tables and managed to pull out a sunset flip, which has completely shocked and bamboozled Kendoll. And Kendoll leaves almost thrown South Shields today with another L in his column. The winner here tonight, Weapon X. Two matches, two wins.
Weapon X continues to impress as he gets the win over Kendoll, who has yet to pick up a victory in 2019. Up next, we have Nicky Starr, who didn't actually have an opponent for this show, so he took it upon himself to issue an open challenge. Let's see who answers the call.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ring the CPW Hardcore Champion, Nicky Starr!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what I gather, Nicky Starr was not scheduled to appear here this evening. But also general manager fracture. And so after a little bit of cajoling, I think he's managed to get himself involved this evening. Oh, I'm not sure in what way. Just for anyone who doesn't know, although it has just been mentioned, Nicky Starr, hardcore champion, and that is normally defended on their 24-7 rule. One half of the Cosplay Kings. Be careful.
So if anyone's smart enough to come out here, I'll take you on right now.
I'll tell you what, if I wasn't sat here with a headset on, I'd be so tempted. Oh! Marcy Wilde! Well, we would ask, why Marcy, why? But we know exactly why. She's making a statement. You're an almost pro. What better way than to answer an open challenge? I think whilst Nicky Starr did see we'd taken any man, woman, child, ring announcer, cameraman, referee, cat, dog, I still think this might come as a surprise to him. And I'm not sure he's taking this seriously. It sounds like Nicky Starr's trying to get out of this and then realised he can't. But like he says, Shield Pro Management have not allowed him to have that hardcore championship on the line.
Nicky
Starr assuring the front row that he won't destroy her. It's like a pantomime. Well, he wants to watch who is behind her because, slap to the face of Nicky Starr. Nicky just regrouping here, trying to work out what his strategy will be. Oh, goes to hit Mars. Oh, blocked! And she has just kicked him in the little Nicky's. Right in the star signals. A short match, and Marcy Wilde doesn't seem to care. Just a swift kick to the star signals and off she pops. Well, he definitely won't be destroying anybody now. And look, Marcy Wilde doesn't care. Yeah. Well, that's just rude. Marcy's asking a question. Why? Marcy, why? I mean, I think she's already made her points, but she could destroy him if she wanted to, and she's decided to. Oh, Nicky Starr just leaps through the air, straight in the wild. Just picking her up. Oh, but it's Marcy who's just laying in with forearms and kicks. And Nicky Starr is on the run. It's like a scene out of Benny Hill. Don't think I've heard the bell ring just yet. Oh! Kick to the head and Nicky Starr. Oh, trying to leap off the ring apron. Marcy caught him and just slammed his spine straight into that ring. Nicky Starr in a lot of pain. Marcy might just go straight to the back again and just telling the audience to move and they'd be wise to heed her. Oh, and it's just a shame she can do what she wants and she just throws Nicky Starr in the ring and we've just hit the bell. Nicky Starr groggy, I don't think he knows exactly what to do here. Wild whips him off. Oh, ducks a clothesline, and again. Oh, sling blades. With a side of disrespect. Oh, Nicky Starr just runs in the corner. He misses, but so does Marcy, and another kick to the head. Nicky Starr looks as though he's setting up to go up that top rope, and oh, just leapfrogs over the top. But I think he's hurt that knee, he has. He's screaming in pain. I think he might have popped his knee when he's come up the top rope. This can't happen. When you're coming down from such a high position. Heard the bell. Guessing this is a win by referee stoppage. I don't know. Let's see what the referee says to the ring announcer. Confirms me. Let's have a look back. Nicky Starr leaping off the top of him. Yeah, he looks very much like he's popped that knee. Well, we've had a bell. Oh, and are we having a restart again? Oh, looks like Nicky Starr will live to regret this. Marcy a while just, kicks the leg and now just stands on that knee. That looks like that's an unnatural angle that he's got that leg out. Nicky Starr crying in the corner, but he can't hide from Marcy Wilde, who just lays in. Oh, again. And the only thing that is in Nicky Starr's favour right now is that his contract hardcore title is not on the line. Oh, lost it through mouth, but he's managed to hold on and he's charged through, but Ross kicks out. You just wonder if the damage has already been done though. Oh, jawbreaker there. Marcy looks just angry and sickened at the same time, laying into those kicks, and Nicky Starr has felt kicks all over his body from her. Oh, this time he ducks and just rolls her over. Is that enough? Only two. Desperation there. Marcy Wilde just stalking him like prey. Gets him off the ropes. Drops him with a clothesline. Nicky Starr Starr will very much be regretting that open challenge right now. Fracture, who he's doing favours for his mates, but I'll tell you what, Nicky Starr will not feel like he's been doing any favours right now. Just laying in. Oh! Now some forearms back from Nicky Starr and a slap! Don't know how Thorn regret, but he's regretting that is now. Oh! Single leg bustle crab. Really laying it in. She's cinching back. The pressure on Nicky Starr, who is right in the middle of the ring. He's got nowhere to go. He's having to rely on just almost like a slug-like way to crawl to them. Nope. He decided to twist over and use a little bit of strength. He certainly had to use the ring ropes to climb up. Now he's trying to run to the corner. Of course, he misses. Manages to counter with a kick to the face. But oh, as he goes to the middle rope, Marcy's wide storm, and now she's just got him all tangled on the rope, and his knee is in absolute agony at the moment as she just throws him over like yesterday's trash. Oh, she just looks down with disdain from the middle rope. And at the moment, Nicky Starr is not going to be counted out, except Marcy Wilde wants to just add some extra punishment as she drags him back up. Oh! Caught her neck on the top rope. Leaps over. Oh! Oh, Marcy is wrestling like a veteran here. And she was well aware of what he was going to try to do. And counted it. And again, goes back to that injured leg. We know Nicky Starr can fly, but she's proved at everything that he's got.
Come on, Nicky, pull her seat, please.
This hooks him in on second suplex. Yes! Beautifully done. Goes to the cover.
Two!
Still only a two. Star off the ropes. Oh, he ducks the clothesline. Oh, and just charges in. Almost like he's got a second wind. Dragging Marcy Wilde by the hair and just flipping her over. Bouncing on those knees. He wants to be careful. We know how much. Oh. Big to kick. Did that spinning suit on, but still not enough to put Marcy Wilde away. Nicky Starr wanting to match kicks with her, and it's not going to happen. Goes to the cover. Still not enough. Thrown into the corner. Beautiful clothesline. What's he going? What on earth? Is it enough? No, Nicky Starr manages to just grab the ropes, and he will be so relieved. I mean, what will it do? His reputation, his. I think she's going for it again. I think she is. And she hits it a second time. Kicked her. Burger box. Followed by a stunner. Still not enough. I don't think he quite caught her. Just slamming that leg off the floor. I think that's a bad idea, especially with the injuries had to his knee. Oh, he catches the kick back with that screaming headbutt.
It's over! Rock and ball!
Woo! Oh! Looks like he's done that sure, do we?
And another kick. The winner of the match, due to another disqualification, Nicky Starr!
Well, it looks like it's 2-1. But he's left them surely with two sore ones. There's yet another kick in the Starsicles. Has left little Nicky even littler. But look at the smile on Marcy Wilde's face.
I doubt anyone expected Marcy Wilde to answer the open challenge. It was very clear she wasn't interested in picking up the win, instead went out there to make a statement. In part one, we saw Oliver Barrett talk his way into the main event. So let's go back to the Almost Pro Arena with our host Lord Gavin Mann, where we see Oliver Barrett take on Domonic Davenport for the Almost Pro Championship.
Bear in mind, everybody, that earlier tonight, Oliver Barrett caught up with our general manager, Fracture, who, bear in mind, is now one of our new tag team champions. He was complaining over the fact that he himself should have been in that number one contenders match. He beat Chase Stryker, and yet it's Chase Stryker getting the opportunity. Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to give props to Fracture here because he listened to that complaint. And Oliver Barrett, is it a number one contenders match or no? He is in a championship match for the Almost Pro Heavyweight Championship. Massive opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event of the evening. And it is sponsored by Thorburn Electrical for all of your electrical needs. This could be the night that we get a worthy champion. And gold returns to Tryback. Down and waits. The champion.
And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, welcome back to the Showman. A man who made a surprise return at the roster roulette and managed to upset Victor Von Vols for the Almost Pro Championship. Who's that silly mare wearing a top hat as if she's some sort of fan? She looks ridiculous. Better if she wore a balaclava backwards. A man who has defended his title against a former nemesis in Kendoll and managed to do so successfully. Now puts his title on the line against Oliver Barrett. And I'll tell you what, Shield management do not give this guy much time to read. Oh! They don't give him much time to prepare, and he wasn't prepared for having his hat knocked off. Oliver Barrett, you can see his face, he can just taste the table. As the Showman hands across the championship to the referee and defrocks himself. The referee shows the title Oliver Barrett and then to the crowd. And of course being second defence for the Showman, the almost pro championship. And a huge, huge, huge opportunity for Oliver Barrett. A man who we know has all the tools to get the job done.
You will never be in my head, shut up!
Interestingly enough, this is the first fight that Barrett and Davenport ever matched up here against each other in Almost Pro. And remember, the winner goes on to face Rev, who's now the number one contender in the main event of its 106 miles to Shieldiversary. So Rev, I'm sure, will be backstage watching this match very carefully. Barrett, I think, just he's a little too eager in the early going. The fans enjoying the fact he's just been thrown straight out of the ring. Meanwhile, the Showman just lays back under the spotlights. Barrett, though, he's determined to just get the advantage of this guy. He pulled the back seat back, but I just think that I think the Showman might be a little bit too heavy. He's not impressed with Barrett's attempts there. He just drives an elbow in. Oh! Just picks him up and just executes the move that I think Barrett was going for with ease and aplomb.
I want to wrestle!
What do you want to wrestle? I'll make it really easy. Come on.
Was it Chairman?
Well, now the Showman is just challenging Barrett to test the strength of Barrett is certainly well defended, but do not think for a second he could match up and test his strength for the likes of Davenport. Davenport is a very powerful individual. We saw that in his match against Victor von Bolton. We've seen that on countless occasions. Oh! Barrett, though, very clever, just doing this. Slap to the face. Drives the Showman into the corner. Oh! Over the top of him, and now a T-bar drag, and another. Ricky Steamboat would be proud. Big back body drop. Barrett's going to have to regroup yet again. Oh, going for a wheelbarrow of sorts, and oh, roll through. Only a two count. But straight back on, and oh, the Magistral. He can taste this title, but he's too eager. Now he just he can't be given up this opportunity. He's walking towards the curtain, but bear in mind, the championship is on the line. Oh, it was a ruse. It was another ruse. And now he's just laying into the Showman on the stage. But I'll tell you what, the Showman just laying in right back. And I don't think Barrett wants to match up a fist fight. Showman or not, he can throw punches with the best of them. Oh, and Barrett just using his wiles. Having to employ every bit of his cunning. He drags up Dominic Davenport, the Showman. And the suplex. A suplex on the ramp. Strong enough to get it, but I'll tell you what, Davenport's strong enough to just bounce, and I mean bounce Barrett off that ramp. of blood as they're begging the showman to bounce him off one more time. Will he oblige? He's listening to them as he just lifts him up. Oh, again. Barrett is like a rubber ball. And the referee is trying to put these guys back in the ring. The referee is Lewis Kelly. An interesting evening. He's given a lot of leeway because, of course, of the magnitude of this. He almost put title is on the line. And now, oh, the showman getting the fans to do his job for him. My words! I think they heard that in heaven. But it's outside the ring, so pretty much legal. Now he's just telling the camera folks to get out of the way. As he just goes to whip. Oh! He went to whip Barrett, I think, into those ring steps, and Barrett, out of desperation, just moved. Oh! Now he's jammed his arm down the side of the ring steps. Now we know that Davenport had issues with an arm. If you can cast your mind back to the reason that Dominic Davenport originally left almost broke, it was because Kendoll beat him in an I Quit match after almost obliterating that or breaking it. Barrett, very smart, very cunning, goes straight after it. He's seen his opportunity and he's gone for it. Oh, and now he's stamping on the arm. Let's have a look back at exactly what he did. As he just backs up, takes a massive run, and just kicks the ring step, which just jammed his arm. Just the cover. I wonder at this stage what state the arm is in. Is Barrett now goes to an armbar and oh, drops the leg across him. If it wasn't broken before, there's every chance in the world that it's broken now. Davenport in absolute agony. We could be seeing a new champion here this evening. And now Barrett just controlling Davenport in the corner. Oh, and wrapping the champion's arm around that ring rope. Oh! And then a drop kick. Look at the strategies that Barrett's employing here. And he is so close to winning that title. He can just feel it right now. Gone is the impetuousness that we saw early in the match. And now he's taking a more measured approach. A suplex knock on his balance, floats over for the cover. Champion kicks out. And now Barrett has him trapped in the centre of the ring. Wearing down the showman. He managed to get to his feet. Blows to the burger box. The ropes. Barrett tries to count out. Oh, he does with a beautiful drop kick. Did you see the height in that? He could have kicked planes out of the sky with that one. He's more than good for the cover. Maybe just waited a little bit too long. Seems to be distracted by the fans, and you can't do that any time in wrestling. Never mind when the title is on the line. You're smacked to that arm. Driving the knees in hard. And you've got to worry about the state of Davenport's arms after he's just gone through all of that punishment. I mean, this guy isn't even going to be able to put his top hat on after this. Snaps him over. first. Davenport goes for the cover. Still only a two. The champion does not want to lose that title. Barrett is like a runaway train. You can see it in his sights. Barrett going to the top. If he hits this, oh! He's almost got that exclamation point. Don't stomp it. Davenport, very wise to it, misses his chance and just lays Barrett out. Oh, and this time a back elbow. Barrett judging him, but I don't think he knows exactly where he is. Stopping the kick in the burger box. Whipped up the ropes. Bounces off. Oh, then just knocked out again. This has got to be it. Barrett manages to kick out, but you can see that in his face he is dizzy and you can't blame him. Davenport is measuring him as Barrett groggily gets to his feet. Barrett trying to get out of that and he's managed. Oh, spine buster. Is this enough? Can he retain his title? Only a two. Stop. He's called a Barrett onslaught. But oh, instead Death Valley driver. So close. Two and four fits. Barrett needs to concentrate though. He's given the champion far too much time to recuperate. Leaps over on him and oh, just slams his back. See the Davenport whilst he was neck first on the ropes. Oh, this is dangerous territory, very dangerous. The neck of the champion is exposed. Oh, he moves out of the way. Oliver Barrett just lands spine first on that unforgiving ring apron. Another breathing. Space has just been acquired by the showman. He looks out, sees where Barrett is. Barrett is dazed. He's on the floor. He's sunbathing out there.
Six.
Seven. I'm glad that woman isn't wearing a skirt. Realizing that he could be in a lot of trouble, just trips over. Davenport rolls back into the ring. He's back on his feet, but he's still losing. Davenport has been hit hard. The referee seems to think that Barrett is pushing him towards. Oh, the referee's busy passing up another turnbuckle. Meantime, Oliver Barrett has undone the middle turnbuckle on the other side of the ring, but oh! It was reversed, but still, the showman tries to charge in. No! Offense block, what's going to try? Huge chop from Barrett. He charges in. Oh, drop toe hold. And Oliver Barrett has gone forehead first into that exposed turnbuckle. Goes for the kick. There he goes. The champion has retained his second defense against a more than qualified Oliver Barrett, who threw everything against him, had a perfect strategy, really worked over that arm, to the point that I will be very surprised if he can do any heavy lifting tomorrow. He's seen off the challenge. It hasn't been a successful night for Tribad, but it's been a great night for the fans of Almost Pro here in the Almost Pro Arena in South Shields. My name's been Well. The number one contender, Rev, interrupts us and just stares across. It's champion looking at champion. And Rev looks as though he wants that belt to add to his collection.
And still your Almost Pro champion. Domonic Davenport retains against Oliver Barrett, which means the main event for next month is set as CWA champion Rev takes on Almost Pro champion Domonic Davenport. We hope you've enjoyed this month's Almost Pro Wrestling. If you have, make sure to subscribe to our channel, youtube.com/Shield Pro Wrestling Presents. Join us next month for Shield Pro Wrestling Presents its 106 miles to Shield anniversary. Tickets are available online at shieldpro.co.uk. From me and all of the team here at Shield Pro, thank you very much for watching.